Alright, welcome back. After releasing their debut album in 1984, titled No Escape, they ditch, Dennis Manzo and replaces it with Dan Bryant. And they also would end up adding a second guitar player named Clint Bower. So you have Clint Bower and Dan Watson taking, giving you that, twin guitar attack on this one. And this is Under the Spell. On here, there's a huge progression from the album. From not just sound like your average heavy metal / power metal band, kind of the same thing with Hellstar. They really end up adding more thrash in their sound. At times, more sounding more like Metal Church than really Hellstar. It's definitely a crossbeat of power metal / thrash metal / speed metal. This is definitely a strong album and my favorite from this band. Hellrider, Edge of Death, The Victim, The Hex, even the title track. Everything about this album is definitely good. Time of War. They really picked up their sound on this album. And even Dan Bryan has such a razor sharp bite to his, approach on the mic. He just has everything, it just cuts through razor or fucking barbed wire. Everything from here is like slicing every bit of bone on the human body. This sound is just a huge step up over the album. It's like definitely competing with the likes of Metal Church, Liege Lord, Hellstar, Obsession, and all the definitely great U.S. power metal bands. This is definitely a U.S. power metal album. And a fucking great one. Not a bad song on this album at all. This album just flows very nicely. Oh, shit. The Victim, like I said, is just a great track. But this would end up being also the last album for Dan Bryant, even though he's back with the band. And of course, the sound is a part of that box set with No Escape, and it's definitely remastered. But after this, they would, Clint Bower, ends up taking, over for vocals on the next album. Release, which was Quest for Sanity, which they just turned into a straight-up thrash metal band. Kind of course, to compete with the likes of Slayer, Exodus, Dark Angel, and, the likes. And at times, even kind of mixing some of that old death metal sound also into, mostly, Possessed, or a really early Death. But even though those two releases, along with, I can't even remember the other album, but it's not a big deal, because obviously that album isn't too bad either. It's their third full-length record, but it's just not a power metal release. They pretty much ditched the whole power metal sound, just became a thrash metal band. Not that those releases are bad. It's just some of those are a little uninspired, in my opinion, than an album such as Under the Spell. But definitely not bad. This is where I end the Hex discography review for U.S. Power Metal Month. So if you have heard Under the Spell, what are your thoughts? If you have any thoughts, post your comments down below. Until then, this is Heavy Thrasher saying I am out. And I'll see you later.